There are four Republicans running for the nomination in Alabama's 2nd Congressional District. The primary winner will face Blue Dog Democrat Bobby Bright in the general election. Bobby Bright votes with Nancy Pelosi over 70% of the time. So, you know, not even sure if he exactly qualifies as a Blue Dog. Alabama's a runoff state. There's a guy named Rick Barber who put a campaign commercial together that blasts the decision to allow a mosque to be built within steps of Ground Zero in New York City. Because of that commercial, which has become a YouTube hit, he is surging, even though he's right now running in second place. Let's welcome on our guest line, Republican congressional candidate Rick Barber. Rick, it's great having you on the Mike Gallagher Show. How are you?
I'm good, Mike. Thanks. How are you?
I'm well. I'll bet you didn't expect the kind of response you got from your commercial, which included the reference to the mosque. But boy, it sure hit a nerve with a lot of Americans. You must be very pleased with the response you got.
I am. And I actually just found out about it last week. This was a very quickly thrown together response, because when I heard about it, it just literally boiled my blood. And I felt that there's had to be others that felt the same way I did. But again, it didn't matter to me, because I just felt the need to be said, because someone needs to start standing up for this country.
And that's what we need in Congress. And so I think that's a message that's going to resonate with Alabamans who say, you know what, we've got to put somebody in office who is able to call a spade a spade. And, you know, it's extraordinarily frustrating to see us struggle with what it means to be an Islamic extremist. I mean, we've got a president who doesn't want to use the word terrorist. This commercial you ran, which we just played, this is something that strikes to the heart of what Americans are concerned about. And I got to believe that even people in Alabama who might seem far removed from the Ground Zero site can appreciate your message.
Well, it actually is not. It's a very close tie-in, because we have immigration problems just like everyone else. And it does tie in immigration, because we're allowing these people to infiltrate our nation. And, you know, in wartime scenarios and even peacetime scenarios, projecting strength and protecting your culture and your borders is key. And when you look at historical Beirut, Lebanon, the Trade Center back in 93, the USS Cole, you go down the list, all the embassies across the country that have been attacked. They haven't been attacked by random groups. They've been attacked by a single source, and that's the Islamic jihadists, and that have absolutely clearly stated they want to destroy us. And if we continue to allow them to come in and believe they're moderate when looking at their beliefs in the Quran and the things they believe in, then we're slowly letting this group of people infiltrate our land, and they will eventually have an impact, as you see in France and France and Europe. And we need to stand up and say something about it.
Let's talk a little bit about who you hope will be your opponent in the general election. Bobby Bright is described as a blue dog. How is somebody a Blue Dog Democrat who votes with Pelosi over 70% of the time?
Well, he has been wise in voting the headline votes in the manner that people view him as somewhat of a conservative. He didn't vote along with Nancy Pelosi on the major health care reform, cap and trade, and some of those. But the big differentiator that's going to hurt him in the primary and in the general election is that he didn't stand up against those things either. And anybody in life really knows you can't lead from behind, and walking a fence is not a way to, in essence, affect change.
And I love your story. I mean, I think all of us, a lot of radio hosts around the country are spotlighting candidates like you, Rick Barber, who have a great story to tell. I mean, you served in the Marine Corps honorably. You served 4 years. You served overseas in Okinawa. You were promoted 4 times. You received citations for excellence. After you served in the Marines, you moved to Montgomery. You took a job with Performance Support, Inc. as a senior systems engineer. You started your own business, and it was a very successful business. You're a great American story. And, you know, I think it's incumbent upon all of us who are broadcasters who support your message. You know, your story needs to be told and, you know, get the word out there. So, again, if it took a commercial, a campaign ad that talked about the jihadists and the absurdity of building a mosque steps from Ground Zero, so be it. At least more and more Americans and people in Alabama are learning who Rick Barber is.
Well, and that's definitely a side benefit. I think the biggest thing that I see happening across the country, and I think why we are doing well, is the fact that people want to see real life experience. In Washington, we have a lot of political records up there. We've got a lot of elite people up there that are very well educated. in the essence of Ivy League schools and things like that. But you know what? They don't have the salt of the earth experience in being in difficult situations, understanding what their freedoms really are, and living in the world that these bureaucrats create, thinking they're positive but realizing they break more than they fix. And people look at folks like myself who have had to earn it in life. Nothing's been given to me. I've been raised in a Christian home and been taught to fight for what you want and work hard for it, and you're going to fail, you're going to make mistakes, but guess what? No success ever comes from not making mistakes. And I think that's what's ringing true with people. But more than anything is standing up and saying what needs to be said, because if you don't get the truth out there, you're never going to get to the bottom of it.
Rick Barber is running for Congress in Alabama. His website is rickbarberforcongress.com, www.rickbarberforcongress.com. And I know there are a lot of people who listen around the country who are supporting candidates like you, Rick. Let's take just a moment and go back to what kind of thrust you into the national spotlight, this commercial. Yesterday, we tackled this for pretty much the first time. Honest to goodness, I read emails last night from listeners who thought I was making it up, that there's no way New York allows a mosque, a Muslim place of worship, to be built steps from Ground Zero, and there's no way the cruelest part of it all, that it's going to be opened up on September 11th, 2011. Rick, it's almost inconceivable that this can happen in the United States of America.
It just shows how numb we've become to identifying threats. And more than that, Mike, they've also named the thing Sharia.
I know.
And anybody who will even pick up, just Google it. I mean, just spend 5 minutes researching the Quran and Islam and what Sharia law means. Islam and a free society cannot coexist. People have got to understand that. That is an oppressive, totalitarian, authoritarian ideology that defies freedom and liberty at its basic core. And if we continue to allow them to come here and manipulate our liberties and our freedom of having a free society that is tolerant of other religion and other beliefs, we will lose it, because they will eventually come here, take over, because we're not willing to project strength and, again, protect and hold very dear to our hearts our protection and liberties that our great founding fathers gave us.
Now, I love the fact that you've been very active with the Tea Party movement going back to 2009. I love people like you who were a Tea Partier before it was cool to be a Tea Partier. On Memorial Day, Vicki Middleton, a friend of ours and a friend of the show's, she's going to be in here along with another great guy, Pastor Stephen Broden. He's a candidate as well and somebody who embraces the Tea Party movement. Speak to a moment, Rick, about the way the left has demonized the Tea Party movement, tried to ridicule it, mock it, and yet it just keeps growing and growing. There's something very special going on in this country with regards to this Tea Party movement, isn't there?
There is. I mean, the biggest thing that impressed me about the Tea Party that really caused me to get more engaged was the fact that these were everyday people. These were your hardworking blue-collar Americans, your grandparents, your business owners that were getting out there and just saying, look, we don't want a handout. We don't want incentives. We just want you to get out of our way. You're encroaching too much on our ability to be successful, pursue our American dream. And that's far different. No one was bussed in on the Acorn buses. No one was paid to be there. These people were taking off their own time, investing their own money to stand up against a tyrannical government that is overtaxing and overbearing. And these people are getting more committed, because the liberal way to try to oppress these groups of people that want to speak out is to call them names. And that fuels these people to get more involved, because they say, look, we're not calling you names. We're just saying you're in our way. You're not supposed to be here. You're not supposed to be doing these things. Government's too big. And at the end of the day, if you keep the argument on the facts, you keep the argument on the issues, you'll win every time. The minute someone goes into the name-calling, they've lost the argument. I think that a lot of people in the Tea Party have realized this, and it's starting to fuel their growth.
Well, we're pulling for you, Rick Barber, in a big way. I hope everybody goes to your site, rickbarberforcongress.com, and supports you. Please stop by and visit with us again. Good luck, and congratulations on having the honor and the integrity and the guts. And, of course, as a Marine, I mean, what else would you offer? But the guts to stand up for what Americans believe in. Keep fighting the good fight, and best of luck to you, okay?
Thanks, Mike. You're a real blessing.
Appreciate you joining us. Rick Barber on the Mike Gallagher Show, running for Alabama's 2nd Congressional District. And again, because of this commercial, it is extraordinary. I mean, it's almost, I wish I should have printed out some of these emails I got last night from listeners who could not believe their ears that there's a mosque being built or a New York community board that approved, 29-1 or 24-1 to let a mosque be built steps from ground zero.